Hello, I'm Andy from Roland. We're down here today at PMT. We're helping you get started with electronic music by busting some of the jargon that you probably come across. So today we're going to talk about a few different things. You can see in front of me here, I've got a few different devices. I've got a drum machine, I've got something to make a bass line, I've got something that I'm going to run a little lead part, and then I've got a mixer to tie it all together. And we're going to use these to make like a little basic tune, but to talk about a few concepts that you're going to come across. So I want to talk about sidechaining. What does that mean? What does a filter mean? An arpeggio, and we'll bring it together to make a little bit of music. So the first thing I'm going to do is I've got my drum machine over here. We made a video before that showed you how to use a step sequencer. If you've not watched that, watch that first. But I'm going to quickly make a little pattern so that we've got some drums going on here. So I've started my step sequencer, choosing my bass drum, and I'm just going to put in what we call a 4-to-the-floor kick, which means that we have a kick on every quarter note. Then I'm going to have some hand claps, and then I'm going to have some offbeat hi-hats. So this is kind of a standard house style beat, and then I'm also going to put in one closed hi-hat to give it a bit of swing. So that's cool, we've got our drums. So at the top on here we have got a bass line. So this has its own step sequencer in it, so you can program in a pattern. We've got this bass line running at the moment. And I want to talk about what a filter does. So you can see on the top here we have two controls that say cutoff and then resonance. So filters are really important in electronic music, and they allow you to create some really, really nice effects. With the cutoff, this is what we call a low-pass filter. So what that means is it allows all the low frequencies, all the bass, the low end, to go through the filter, but it takes away the high end. So as I bring down the control, you can hear the sound will get darker. A bit more bassy as it goes down, and then brighter as it goes. The resonance control, which goes hand in hand with the low pass filter, so what this does is it adds a volume boost at the little point that we're cutting off. So as we're taking away that high end, the resonance control is adding a big boost. So if I put some resonance up and then we do a filter sweep, it'll sound different. You can hear that quacky kind of sound to it. So that's really cool. You can use that for quite a nice kind of different effects. The other thing that we're going to do with the bass line is we are going to do a thing called sidechaining it. So to illustrate sidechain, I'm just going to pull down these controls. And I'm going to run this sidechain from a mixer. So what is sidechaining? It's all over dance music nowadays. And essentially what it means is that it sort of ducks the volume of one instrument. So it'll take we're going to have our bass line and it's going to be going at a certain volume level, and it's going to bring down the volume at certain points. And what that allows you to do is it allows other instruments to shine through. So we're going to do it with the kick drum. So what I'm going to do from my mixer over here is I'm just going to mute out this little synth on my drum machine for the moment. So start it. So you can hear we've got our bass line on here. And we have another step sequencer that's running on the top on here. So if I choose my sidechain effect on the MX1 on the mixer on here, and if I put my sidechain effect on 1, 5, 9, and 13, you can hear what that's doing there. It's like ducking it on the downbeat of the track. So that's with that. That brings in. And why is that cool? Because now we have our kick drum, which if you remember is on the same notes on there. So now when I bring that in, so essentially what it's doing without the sidechain, just plays the bass line all the way through it. But when we have the sidechain on, you can hear it's doing that pulsing kind of effect, which is really good for dance music. So that's really cool. So the other thing that we wanted to talk about is an arpeggiator. So what is an arpeggio? So on a piano or on a keyboard or anything like that, you can play chords. So if I wanted to play C minor, which is these three notes, C, E flat, and G, I'm playing all three notes together as a chord. But if I played them individually, that's playing what we call an arpeggio. So it splits up the chord and it plays it in the individual notes. So on a lot of synthesizers, you have a thing called an arpeggiator. And what that does is it allows it to do it automatically for you. So if I play C minor as a four note chord, so I've got C, E flat, G, and then an upper C, you can hear that's playing it in order. It's going quite slowly, but we can change the speed of that. So this is doing it in quarter notes. I could put it on eighth notes, or I could put it in 16th notes. And over here we have an arpeggiator type. So this is just going up one octave and it's just repeating it. I could have it going up and down, or down, or we could do the same over two octaves. And in fact, on this keyboard, we have a couple of options for doing different patterns as well. So that can be quite cool. And if you apply things like some effects to those, so if we've got a bit of delay. So these can be quite good for little textures. We can even apply a little filter to that as well. And make some nice kind of sound effects. So what we can do now is we can bring all of this together and we can start making our own little kind of piece of music here. So we're going to start with our bass line. So I'm using this as well to sync everything for tempo. So it's quite good as well if you have different devices. I mean, if you're on a computer, this isn't really so much of an issue, but if you are using bits of hardware, try and sync them together so that you have tempo everything. So I'm syncing everything from the MX1 here. We're on 124 BPM at the moment. So if I hit start on this one, we'll hear our bass line. Still got that side chain going. All my faders down apart from my kick drum, so if I bring in the drums now, we'll just get the kick. And if I bring up my synth, we'll hear some arpeggio. And you can hear everything is in time. I could speed it up, or I could slow it down, and it all stays together, which is cool. But what we can do now is we can filter things like individually, so I could go back and filter my... I can mute out different elements. And then we can start building up a bit of a performance if I bring in the hi-hats. Other little things that we can do, we have a shuffle control on this. Shuffle just gives a bit of groove, bit of feel. It sort of takes those mid notes in between the big hits and slides them away to give it more of a human kind of feel. So. And of course you can bring in different elements. You know, you can bring in whatever kind of thing you want. If you've got a singer, you can do a vocal, that's great. This is all really just to kind of get you started really, and I hope explaining those little terms will help you out. So. We have filters, we have arpeggiators, we have side chaining, we have our drums put together. If you can combine all of those different elements together, you've got a great way of getting started in electronic music. So I hope this has been useful for you. We'll see you next time.
So thanks for watching, and thanks to Andy from Roland for coming down today and having a chat with us. For more information on any of the gear that you saw Andy using, visit pmtonline.co.uk. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, facebook.com/pmthouseofrock. And as usual, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you again soon.